So now we are going to read something about the storing. Okay. So why the crops has to be stored? How it has to be stored? See, the farmers are very happy. Okay. They have seen the crops, the golden thing. It's equivalent to gold for them. Okay. It is there in the field. Okay. Now cutting is done. That means it, the threshing is completed, winnowing is completed. Okay. Now crops are ready with them. The grains, I should say rather. Okay. It is ready with them. But, and they want to see, obviously all the farmers, they grow the crops to sell it. So for selling, how they are going to sell it? The whole stock, they cannot keep it with them. They have to sell it. So for selling the crops, it can't be taken in the open way to the market. That means it needs a sort of a packaging. Okay. And one more thing, when the farmers want to sell the crops, when they are in talks, you know, they are in talks with someone, the one who will purchase their crop, all this process is time consuming. They just can't leave the crop like this only. So they have to pack it. Pack it in what? The crops has to be packed in the, they may use the gunny bags, the jute bags, okay. The crops has to be packed and has to be brought to the place where it is, it has to be, or it can be sold. So where it can be sold? In different grain markets. Okay. So before this, before selling of the crops, how and what are the ways to keep the crops safely? Okay. So because it's very, very important to store the crops properly. If the crops are not stored properly, the whole efforts of the farmers may be just, it may just go like this only. It may, the whole efforts will be wasted. Why it will be wasted? Because the crops, the grains will always be in danger of being attacked by the some rodents, maybe bacteria, fungus, virus, maybe insects. Okay. So how the crops has to be protected, how the grains can be protected, we are going to read that. Okay. So it needs to be protected from abiotic factors. It needs to be protected from abiotic factors as well as biotic factors. Okay, so the crops, the grains need to be protected from what? It has to be protected from abiotic factors and biotic factors. Now, what is the meaning of abiotic and biotic factors? See, bio means life. Okay, bio means what? Life. So, whatever living things. Okay, there is a danger from some kind of living things. So what can be those living things? It can be maybe rodents. Maybe rodents like rats. Maybe insects. Okay, maybe few insects. So maybe the stray animals, you know. So crops has to be protected from these biotic factors. I should even write the bacterias, okay, fungi and even viruses. Okay, it needs to be protected, the crops, the grains needs to be protected by rodents, it needs to be protected by insects. It needs to be protected by stray animals also and from bacteria and fungi also. Now, what is the meaning of abiotic? When I said biotic means living, so what can be the meaning of abiotic? Non-living. Okay, so what is the meaning of abiotic? it is non-living. Okay, now when I say non-living, can non-living things also affect the crops? Can non-living thing also affect the grains? Can you just give a thought? Can you just try to recall the things in your mind, or try to give use some logics? What can be the abiotic thing which can spoil the grains? Okay. So what are the things? See, I'll help you out. It can be temperature. Okay. It can be temperature. I'll explain you how it can affect. Okay. Next can be humidity. And one more thing which can be moisture. See, what can be, how the crops, how what we are studying now, how the crops can get spoiled, how and from what we need to protect the crops from. Okay, there are two kind of factors, abiotic factors and biotic factors. Abiotic factor means I have put A over there, that means they are non-living. So whatever non-living conditions are there which are responsible for spoiling the crops. Okay, this is the one thing. Now second thing is, whichever the living things are there which can spoil the crops. So the crops can get spoiled by two ways, living things and non-living things. So now we are going to study how the crops can be, how these things affect the crops and can bring a big problem for the farmers, can be troublesome for the farmers. First of all, to start with, I have written abiotic factors above that. So we are going to read effect of temperature. Okay, now effect of how the temperature can affect. See, I'll tell you one thing, the crops, the grains are always now seed, no? For sowing the, for getting new kind of crops, we need to sow the seeds only, the grains which I have got now. So the temperature, the if at a, like, you know, at particular temperature, the enzymes, the microorganisms, the insects, they become very, very active. Okay. So that particular temperature needs to be prevented. Like, see, most of the organism, they become very, very active from 30 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. This is the most active period, active temperature I should say. This is the temperature at which what will become active? The enzymes which can spoil the seed or the grains, and many insects, they become active. Even the microorganism, which kind of microorganism? What we have done, written bacteria, fungi, viruses, all this can spoil the crops. Okay, so what they actually do, like from 30 to 35 degrees Celsius, the number of this, like, you know, it is very, very comfortable from this temperature, is very, very comfortable for this bacteria, for fungus, for maybe rodents, maybe insects. Okay, so it needs to be protected. So from protecting this, the grains has to be kept below this temperature. Are you getting it? This temperature is this temperature has to be, like the farmers say, avoid keeping the crops to this temperature. Understood? So temperature, and you know, one more thing I'll tell you, when this temperature is there, 30 to 35 degrees Celsius, what I said, the number of insects will increase. Okay, the number of rodents or the number of bacteria and fungi will increase. So now when the number of insects will increase, they will respire, they have to breathe. I am breathing, you are breathing, they will breathe. And respiration is a kind of exothermic reaction. They are going to produce heat. Okay, what will be produced? heat will be produced, and this heat which is produced by these animals will be again harmful for the what? Grains, because again the temperature is increased. Okay, so what we have understood, what we are reading about, we are reading about temperature. 30 to 35 degrees Celsius of the temperature is very suitable for the insects and microorganisms. ठीक है, okay, it is very very suitable for what? This temperature is very very suitable for the insects as well as for whom? For the microorganisms. So what has to be done now for microorganisms? ठीक है, so when it is suitable for them, so what has to be done? What? We have to reduce the temperature. That means the grains have to be kept below this temperature. ठीक है ना, below this temperature. Okay, the crops has to be kept below this temperature. Now this is the part which I need to again proceed from here only. Now when if insects will increase, what will happen? They will respire. Okay, due to respiration, what will happen? Heat will be produced. Due to respiration, heat will be produced. Heat will be produced, which will be further spoiling the grains. Which will be further spoiling the grains. Once again we will see what we are talking about. We are talking about how the crops can, you know, how the crops can be attacked by the insects, maybe by the bacteria and fungi, and what and how it has to be prevented. So temperature, when we talk about 30 to 35 degrees Celsius, the insects, the microorganisms, it is very comfortable. Like this temperature is very very comfortable for microorganisms and the insects. Okay, so they enjoy, they have a very good time, because they will be getting very good grains, good thing to eat. So we don't want that, we don't want to spoil the crops. So what has to be done? The food grains has to be kept below this temperature, and if the farmers fail to do so, what will happen? This insects will come, this insects, the number of insects will increase, and when this insects will come, they are going to do like what they will do? They will respire. Now respiration is an exothermic process, and so heat will be produced due to the respiration of these kind of insects, and when the heat is produced, again it spoils the grains further. Okay, so this was the first factor, temperature. Now we will talk about second. So second is what? Humidity. Okay, now what is the meaning of humidity? The amount of moisture. Okay, the amount of moisture which is present in the air. Okay, that is what? Humidity. Now see, for any kind of life, okay, for any kind of life, water is very very important. Okay, now if I'm saying that moisture is available in the atmosphere, so what will happen? The insects, okay, the insects are going to use this humidity, and again they are going to attack the grains. Okay, again they will be attacking the grains. So whenever the place where the grains has to be stored, okay, what has to be done? Like there should be no humidity in the एटमोसफियर इट शुड बी लाइक हैविंग द ड्राई कंडीशंस. द ड्राई कंडीशंस शुड बी देयर बिकॉज ह्यूमिडिटी अगेन इंक्रीज द ग्रोथ ऑफ द बैक्टीरिया, फंगाई, वायरसेस, ओके, एंड ऑल्सो ऑफ वेरियस काइंड ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट व्हाट वी रेड अबाउट. So now what we read about, temperature, and now again what is the humidity. Now what is humidity? The amount of water present in the atmosphere okay, the amount of water present in the atmosphere is called as humidity. Okay, now we have like what has to be done? This humidity has to be blocked up. So which kind of storage, where the storage or place should be there, which kind of godowns should be there? It should be dry, like the places where the food, the grains has to be stored, it needs to be of which kind? It should be of dry. That means to protect, what has to be done? Dry conditions. Dry conditions has to be maintained. Okay, dry conditions has to be maintained. Now the third one which we are going to talk about is moisture. Can you relate this humidity and moisture? What is moisture and what is humidity? Just now I told, what is humidity? The moisture which is present in the air. Okay, the moisture which is present in the air is known as humidity. Then I am talking about moisture, when I say, when I talk about moisture, it then what it is? Moisture is the presence of water inside the grains. Okay, moisture is the amount of water which is present inside the grains. So you know, by the, when we talk about, I will write here only moisture so that it can be quite comfortable. Okay, it is a, like, see, this is a demarcation line. So now we have to read moisture. What is the difference between moisture and humidity? Humidity is the presence of water in the atmosphere, in the place where the grains are spreaded, or the place where the grains are packed, kept. There the amount of air inside, in the amount of water in the air is humidity. But what is moisture? The amount of water which is present inside the grains. Okay, so what can, what happens now? Why water should not be there in the grains? See, you know, when the crops are being cut, okay, when the harvesting is being done, it is kept in the mind that it is dried properly. You know, if the wet grains are stored, okay, if the wet grains are stored, definitely there will be what? Great amount of, or the number of the insects, rodents, bacteria, fungi, fungus is not going to leave the food like this. Okay, so it is going to increase and definitely it is going to spoil the crops. So we are going to discuss now about the third factor. Okay, so what is the third factor? It is what? Moisture. We will talk about moisture now. What we are talking about? Moisture means what? The amount of water present in the grains. See, first thing, during the harvesting, before the harvesting, before the crops are being cut, the farmers has to keep this thing in the mind, and they keep it, they do it. Okay, that the crops, the grain should not be wet. If the grains are wet, what will happen? It will increase the growth of the fungus. Okay, so first of all, the harvested crops should not have more water in it. You know, the amount of moisture in the grains should not be more than 14% by its weight. Okay, the amount of water in the grains should not be more than 14% by their weight. You know, second thing, if the moisture is there, okay, what will happen? The seed will start germinating there itself. Germination of seeds takes place. Okay, germination of seeds takes place. Just to recall, you know, to remind you one thing, you might have seen potatoes at home. Okay, from the potatoes, some yellow color structure comes out. Okay, this is the potato. You might have seen something like this, which comes out from the potato. Okay, and if you allow this thing to grow, okay, what will happen? The potato will get rotten. It is going to get spoiled. Okay, so like farmers can't allow the seeds to germinate. If the germination of the seeds takes place there itself, then what will happen? The seed is going to totally get, it will, what will happen? It will totally get destroyed. The seed is going to get destroyed. So germination of seeds takes place, which is very, very harmful. So, you know, to get rid of moisture, what can be done? Okay, we don't want moisture in the crops, in the grains. So just try to recall what your mother does when everybody eats grain, everybody has to store grains. Okay, so when, just try to recall when the wheat is, suppose you have purchased wheat, two bags of wheat. So what has to be done? Can we keep it like this in the bags only? No, we can't. Then what can be done? What your mother does? Does she open and put it into some big container? She does it. But before this, what she does, it is a very old and traditional method. Method means what has to be done? Sun drying. Okay. What is this? Sun drying. Important is drying, है ना? Drying of seed is very, very important. If you try to remember, see, everybody know about the papad. Okay, papad, when papad is being made at home, and it has to be spreaded separately. Similar is the case with grains. In this, like same, like when the papads are made, and if it is kept one upon another in the wet condition only, then what will happen? Totally it is going to be, totally it will get spoiled. What will happen? Lot of fungus will grow on that. And a lot of fungus will grow on that. You will find papad turning white. Okay. So what is happening? Because of moisture, fungus has attacked over there. So here also what will happen? If the crops, the grains are little wet, if there is amount of moisture, if the water is present in the grains, then what will happen? It is going to get germinate. Okay, or second thing, the fungus are going to attack. So what our motto is, it has to be, the water has to be removed from there, hai na? The water has to be removed from there. So how it can be done? sun drying. What is sun drying? See, what the farmers do, they spread the grains on the large span, maybe in the field or some area where the sun rays can fall and reach the grains. One very important point, the farmers will never spread the grains directly on the surface of the earth, on the soil. Why the seeds will not be spread directly on the surface of the grains, on the surface of the earth? Because the grains, if it is spread directly on the surface of the earth, if the earth is little bit wet, what the seeds are going to do, what the crops are going to do? They will absorb the water from the soil, okay? They will absorb the water from the soil, and again the same process, it may get germinated or it may get, the fungus may attack, okay? So what is the case? Sun drying is very, very important. What is sun drying? To allow the seeds, or we can say seeds are spread in presence of the sunlight on the long sheets. Okay, the process of drying the seeds in presence of sunlight, okay, the process of drying the seeds in presence of sunlight. Now, what are the important things? The sunlight has to be given, but the seeds will never be spread directly on the floor. See, I told first thing, like the seeds are going to absorb the water. But the second problem is what? If it is spread on the land, in the fields, so the mud, the particles, the soil will come along with the grains when the grains are gathered, hai na? When the grains has to be gathered, what will come? The soil, the mud, the crystals of the particles of the mud, again it is going to come with the grains, okay? So it's of no use, and again it has to be cleaned up. So it has to be spread on what? It has to be spread on the sheets or something has to be there, okay? So at home also, if you remember, your mama, if she spreads the grain, she is not going to spread it directly on the floor. She is going to use one or the other thing. On that, she is going to spread the seeds. Okay. So we have read till now about the abiotic factors. What is the meaning of abiotic factors? A means what? Which is like biotic means living, abiotic means non-living. What are the dangers? Temperature. Okay. So like, see, even we need certain things, like we need water, we need comfortable temperature. If it is very cold, we can't survive. If it is very hot, it is problematic for us. So in the same way, even the microorganisms, even the insects, they need a particular temperature, okay? They need water also, as we need. They are also living things. So whenever, wherever they get all these things in the proper amount, in a comfortable amount, then what happens? They start germinating. They start growing. No, they start growing. They start attacking. So just a quick recap. These are the things: temperature, humidity and moisture, which attacks the crops. A very important point: humidity means the amount of moisture which is present in the atmosphere, and moisture means the amount of water which is present in the grains. So grains needs to be protected from all this, okay? Now, when we talk about biotic factors, okay, rodents, insects, stray animals. See, stray animals so need to be protected, like well, boundaries should be there, okay. How it can be protected? Boundaries should be there, like there should be no place for the animals to get inside. When we talk about rodents and insects, okay, what has to be done? Some chemicals has to be spreaded, okay, chemicals has to be spreaded, like say for example DDT. But I would like to focus on one point, like in India DDT is used, okay, but this is a very bad aspect, very bad part of this, that it is banned in foreign countries because it is very very harmful. It pollutes atmosphere, at the same time it also affects, it is very very dangerous for the health of the animals and the human beings, okay. So DDT is used, but in fact it should not be used, okay. Whatever things which is having both kind of, you know, it is useful for us, but at the same time it is more dangerous and harmful also. So rather some good alternatives should be seen for, okay. So where the place where the this grains are stored, okay, are known as granaries or maybe godowns, okay. Now it can be stored in the very big halls, okay. So now when the at the places like godowns, when the seeds or when the the grains are stored, okay, so what has to be done before storing the grains, what points which has to be focused before the storing of grains, okay, because now the all the, like as I said, the crops, the grains should not have the moisture. The farmers have cut or harvested the crops at the very right time. There is perfect amount of water in the seeds, okay. Now what is the next thing, like where it has to be taken and what are the things which is very very essential, okay, which has to be kept in mind